This is the Penn State Forage Particle Separator. It's designed very much similar to the ASABE separator, where we can actually calculate mean particle size, and in the mathematics has been worked out very well for us to look at average particle size of a feed. It has screens that are 19 millimeters, 7 millimeters, 4 millimeters to give us effective fiber, and then a bottom pan. Now, one of the unique features about this is that the thickness of the screens are proportional to the diameter of the holes, and that's one of the things that makes it work. There's also available a screen which is 1.18 millimeters. That's actually been determined to be the average size of a piece of feed leaving the rumen of a cow. Some people may want to use that. It gives us very fine particles and tells us the amount of those fine particles in the feed or TMR. But a lot of people are more concerned about looking at physical effective fiber, and that's where the 4 millimeter screen comes in. Everything above that is considered physical effective fiber. Everything below that is considered something that's very small, even though its average particle size is greater than 1.18 millimeters. Okay, so what we do with this is it's calibrated with 3 dry points of material. We put that silo on here, or in here. It's meant for a wet feed. And then what we're going to do is that we shake it 40 times. So we take 5 shakes, turn it, and we do that 8 times. The idea is that you're trying to get all the feed to go back and forth on these screens, allowing anything that's small enough to pass down through. And the key thing in terms of shaking it is to give it enough force so that your feed or TMR is able to pass back and forth over those holes, allowing it to pass down through, realizing that you've got feed that is trying to pass all the way down into the bottom. So, the only small thing that you have to keep in mind if you happen to have silages that has a lot of clumps in it, when you're about halfway through, you need to make sure that they would be all on the top and you need to break those up. In this case, I didn't have any. What we do with this from here on in is that we take what's remaining on each of these screens, we weigh it, record the weight, and then on our website you will find a spreadsheet that you download, and you can put the numbers in there, and it'll plot mean particle size for you and give you a distribution. Or you can simply add up each of the amounts in the tray and then look at the fraction, the proportion that's on the top, second tray, third tray, and bottom tray. Those are ones where you'll go back to a table and calculate, well, based on what type of aeration this is a percent that it should be in that, and is your feed stuff in the range of where it should be.